wondering how could I be so far from my home. And my mind is somewhere else, but when I find it, I'll patch up where it's been blown. Now I'm just floating on the breeze, and I feel I'm falling like these leaves. I must be cornerstone. Oh, but when I reach that ground, I'll share this peace of mind I found. I can feel it in my bones, but it's gonna take a little time for me to set that parking brake.
Okay, we're fixing to have to remove that housing. You can see right here. This housing is the secondary fuel filter housing. And actually, okay, this thing is held on with 3 9/16 bolts. I'm sure the proper way would be to pull the filter, pull all the lines off, but we're going to hopefully, these bolts aren't long and I don't have to pull the filter. But if I do, I got a filter. I got a feeling filter's going to have to come off. In fact, before we go too much further, let's pull the fuel filter.
So
showing that part again with my phone. As you can see, this is where the fitting went. And it screwed up all them threads. That's a bus fitting. I'm gonna show you. It went right behind that fuel filter. I put the filter back on just to keep shit out of my engine. And it goes to right there on the compressors where that pipe.
Where'd I put the pipe?
There's the pipe. That's that pipe that goes to the compressor. Fits there to there. But like I said, Caterpillar came out with a new thing. Anyway, this is the old air blow-by chamber box. That's where it's stripped. And we're fixing to do a repair. That'll work better. Turn this like this. That camera ain't picking up good. Move some of this. All right, you see where that new fitting goes into that bracket behind that fuel filter housing? And that new stainless steel hose goes up to the air compressor into that new fitting. We changed the box, the fittings, the hose, and fixing to put the fuel filter back on.